ever get the feeling you've been cheated?
When you go looking for surf, you don't look for a really big wave. If you found one, you'd never ride it in strange waters. It would be much too dangerous. What every surfer dreams of finding is a small wave with perfect shape, what we call a perfect wave. The odds against finding that are 10 million to 1.
Bruce Brown follows two young surfers around the world in search of the perfect wave. It is the ultimate surfing adventure, crossing the globe from the uncharted seas of Africa to the shark-filled waters of Australia, to the paradise of Tahiti, the otherworldliness of New Zealand, and to surfing's homeland of Hawaii. This timeless masterpiece continues to capture the imagination of every new generation and is probably the most important documentary ever made about surfing. Could this be the most feel-good movie of all time? The film was directed, produced, edited, and narrated by Bruce Brown. He's best known for surf films, although he's also made excellent documentaries about motorcycling and skateboarding. With The Endless Summer, Brown creates a film so powerful, it encouraged many surfers to travel abroad, giving birth to the surf and travel culture, with prizes for finding uncrowded surf, meeting new people, and riding the perfect wave. The film follows the adventures of Robert August and Mike Heinsohn. It also features great surfers of the time, such as Mike Dora, Phil Edwards, and Butch Van Aardsdale. Our three intrepid travelers journey to the coasts of Australia, New Zealand, Tahiti, Hawaii, Senegal, Ghana, Nigeria, and South Africa. I recently rewatched The Endless Summer. I was surprised at how positive this film still is today. The film is pure Prozac for the soul. It's boundless joy. Surf movies and documentaries today are all about the endless winter and the search for the big waves. And I get that. Pulling these modern day gladiators into 50-foot waves at Nazaré with jet skis is awe-inspiring, but something has been lost from the innocence of good vibes and the search for the endless summer. This documentary has the frontier spirit of America we seem to be lacking these days. It is the constant search for undiscovered countries. Man's desire for new conquest is not toxic masculinity. It can take many forms. It is the drive to build better computers, medicines to improve the lives of the many, or simply to find the perfect wave. Under the facade of fun, there is the individual struggle to find meaning and a reliance on yourself. The beauty of the world is undeniable, but nature can be unforgiving. For all man's planning, you can't fight the forces of nature. You're just along for the ride. On the manly meter, it scores 5. Men were just more manly 50 years ago. This film was made over half a century ago. How would today's woke culture view this documentary? Surfing itself could be considered cultural appropriation, as it originates in Hawaii. It would be seen as white men stealing from indigenous people and exploiting it for money. Although this film shows female surfers, there would have to be far more representation to be considered gender equal. Yesterday's pioneers are today's problematic patriarchy. But forget all that woke nonsense. These guys are legends.
How does that happen? How do you become, like, how does somebody turn into some legend?
Just get old? You get old enough, you may become a legend.